Hello everyone, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'd like to talk about ANSYS Mechanical APDL. The term APDL means ANSYS Programmable Development Language. It is akin to Abacus Python scripting, a lot less powerful, but a lot easier to learn. APDL works only with ANSYS Mechanical APDL, not with Workbench or anything else as far as I know. It is a hidden treasure that ANSYS Inc. does not advertise, but old-timers like me swear by it and won't let it go. The advantages of APDL are many. Number 1, you can reuse your code, just like any code, MATLAB, Python, you name it, but with APDL you are not doing algebra or matrix operations, you are running full-blown ANSYS simulations. Any change to your model, just type different dimensions, or material properties, and run again. Number 2, no mouse clicks. Unlike ANSYS Workbench or similar, that require a gazillion mouse clicks, APDL is just code. For those of you that, like me, have some hand pain from so much mouse clicks, APDL is a blessing. And beware, excessive use of repetitive motions, such as mouse clicks, can lead to debilitating health problems. Number 3, documentation. APDL code is plain text, it can be read, understood, and reviewed by anyone, it can be sent in the body of an email, and it will likely work with past and future versions of ANSYS Mechanical, no more annoying messages saying that you need to update your version of the software to open database files. So, I downloaded and installed the student edition of the whole ANSYS suite, to show you how to use APDL. So, where is it? From Windows Start, find ANSYS here. Among a lot of software, find Mechanical APDL 2021 R1, not plain Mechanical, above, not Mechanical APDL product launcher, below. This is the graphical user interface, GUI. You can use the GUI to build a model. We start by invoking the preprocessor module. Element type. Add element. Solid. Quad 4 node 182. Options. Key op 3. Plane stress with thickness. Real constants. Add. Thickness, set it to 4 millimeters. Material properties. Material models. Structural. Linear. Elastic. Isotropic. Now we save the model database and the log file simultaneously. A previous model database is overwritten, but the log file information is appended, keeping a record of everything that you did on the GUI. Now we open the log file. The top of the file is what I did in a previous session. This is what I did next, but old stuff anyway. And this is what I did for you, using the GUI, just a minute ago. We can clean up the log file, some lines are redundant, but you can identify the lines that matter because they are similar to what we did with the GUI. I finished the model offline, and once I cleaned up the log file, I got this. The shaded area is the model itself. I copy, then paste it back into a clean session. To execute it, press enter on the keyboard. And there you have it, the script does everything. Any changes in dimension, material properties, whatever, just modify the script and run it again. Okay, that's it for today. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, and click the bell to enable notifications. You can find more details in the textbook, by following the link in the description. Thank you.